Thanks for the opportunity. Can you hear me? I don't hear it from loudspeakers, but okay, but people are nodding, so probably it's okay. Right. So glad to be here. I suppose most of us have heard that artificial intelligence is kind of a popular topic at the moment. This is an example from the main conference of the machine learning field, Neural Information Processing Systems, NIPS. So this is the number of registrations, so tickets sold to a conference. Time goes in this way in days, and the conference time is somewhere on the right. And each curve is now 1 year. And as you can see, the curves rise on consecutive years, and the rise actually increases until last year, 2017. The sales exploded immediately as the tickets came available and hit the ceiling, which was the number of people who can be fitted due to fire regulations to the buildings. And it was sold out. A boring mathematical conference where people give mathematical talks. This is something I haven't heard before. Of course, part of this popularity of AI is due to the hype. But there is some serious undercurrents, and for instance, the NIPS is a very serious conference, even though the hype is causing some people who are not so serious to go there, but there is some big things happening, definitely. Finland is actually not a bad place to do artificial intelligence at the moment. So Accenture's estimate is saying that Finland is the second in the world in the growth potential due to AI, next to US. Finland's government is actually awake as well. There is a Finland's AI program that is being implemented as we speak. And Finland is actually rather strong in AI. So there are some names in the recent history, Kohonen, Oja, many of you may have heard about. There's a critical mass at the moment in Helsinki of about 30 professors with their research groups working on artificial intelligence. In the community of 100 or so ICT professors with their groups, and an additional 100 working on digitalization-related things. So this is definitely a critical mass. And now for companies, these things obviously are competitive advantages. So now there is no excuse to actually for the companies to do well also by leveraging on this competitive advantage. So with AI, it is possible to do the current things more efficiently, but more importantly, in new ways and to do new things. And that's what causes disruptions, as we know. What is special in IT, and in particular artificial intelligence, is that the distance from the research to products can be surprisingly short. Unfortunately, that is only available, that can be leveraged only by people who actually have expertise, so who have already invested long term. Competition is tough, and expertise is really the bottleneck. So fortunately, we do have the expertise. So there's the community that I just mentioned, and the Finnish Artificial Intelligence Center is a partnership by Aalto University, University of Helsinki, and 15 companies and increasing. What we aim to do is to solve three bottleneck problems hampering progress of AI at the moment. So the first one is, we all know that there is big data that can be used for deep learning in order to improve in particular image recognition, speech recognition, and so on, to be much better than what humans can do. But this is not true for all problems, unfortunately. In particular, if we are talking about big data, it's typically a huge collection of very small data, and then if each of these small data can be used for solving different problems, in total a really big number of problems, but for each of these small problems, there is not so much data. So the same techniques don't work for everything, we need also additional techniques. The other problem is that AI cannot be depended on preserving privacy to be secure. And the third problem is that humans typically don't understand AI if it's very complicated, and vice versa, AI does not understand the humans. So AI understanding humans, we can do something about. Humans understanding AI, we can help by educating people, which is one of the impact things that we are actually striving for. So how this works is we work with the companies trying to find really hard problems that we can solve together such that the solution would be both the problem and solution would be useful to both. And then we aim to help with this expertise gap by education and attracting more talent. So what's in it for my company? So very concretely, we are looking for interesting problems to solve together better than any one of us could do separately. So EU's privacy legislation will make using data harder. So assume, or what if, we would be able to learn from data without sacrificing privacy at all? What if we could replace the difficult mathematical derivations by programming? And which has been done, for instance, by Markus Ojala, who is an alumni from this community, who has used a probabilistic programming language, STAN, for maximizing revenue for ad spend, which is in production use. Next talk is by one of our partners, Curious AI, on how to do new kinds of deep learning. This example could be for solving the problem of lack of expertise by producing fake experts or fake celebrities in this case. But actually, this is an eye-catching example of how to use simulator-based inference to learn much better hard problems. And this is also one case study of how to do collaboration together with companies. So this was done by Professor Jaakko Lehtinen, who is shared between NVIDIA and Aalto University together with his group. Of course, there is the standard way of working together with recruitments. Is hiring good students from our community and key data science and AI people in very many companies are actually from this community. F-Secure, Nokia, Reactor, many startups. So collaborate in education, join the network of a huge number of really interesting companies. In the sold-out AI day that we organized in December, there were 180 companies present. In Slush, there is 400 AI companies over in the last Slush. And maybe the key thing here is that the expertise is the bottleneck. So all experts have actually hands full of really interesting things to do. So what we can do together is to find even more interesting or more important things to do. That's how you can compete of the expertise. And here are some of the key persons. Thanks a lot for your attention.